多国内家庭在寻求代母服务的时候，最关切的莫过于如何确保自己的胚胎在代母的体内也能够受到最好的呵护。而美国代母又必须符合哪些条件才能够担任代母的工作？曾经协助超过2500多个家庭找到完美代母的 Brisman 将为我们做详细的说明。
Carriers have to be over 21. They have to have given birth before. Usually they're under 40. They have to have their own families. They have to be financially stable. No complications.
Financially stable, but they still want to be a carrier?
Correct. Normally they come from working class families where they do have income and someone in the family has a job. A lot of times the moms are stay-at-home moms or they may work, but normally they're not working significant number of hours, so that they have time to do this.
And they can really supplement the household financial by doing this as well.
Yeah, normally it's a combination of reasons that they're doing it. Mm-hmm. Part of it is the financial, and part of it is they really don't have any issues being pregnant. They feel a lot of pride in being able to help another couple. There's the American Society of Reproductive Medicine, and they issue guidelines on what a carrier should be like physically, mentally, stability-wise. So for instance, your carrier should be over 21. It is best if she's given birth to a baby before. She should have a psychological evaluation. She should have an independent lawyer. So most clinics do follow those guidelines. There's only a certain number of births and pregnancies that carriers could have had in order to qualify.
So, I mean, the carrier could have gone through multiple pregnancies for other people?
Yes, they can have multiple pregnancies, but for instance, they can't have an enormous number. We're looking at the carrier screening from a medical perspective, but we're also testing for drugs, alcohol, nicotine on the carrier, and if she's married her spouse. We're doing criminal background checks.
Oh, you do the criminal background check, I mean, for both the carrier as well as the spouse?
Yes, because I want to make sure that there's no issues of domestic violence in the home. So I'm going to check the domestic violence registries and make sure that there hasn't been any instances in the home. And also, we are going to send a social worker to the home to make sure it's a safe place.
How many carriers are you working with, I mean, currently?
At any time, we have about 200 matches going on.
Oh, my goodness.
So a lot.
It's a lot, and that's out of how many? Like, because I suppose you have to expand your pool to get to that 200.
Oh, we accept about 1-5% of the carriers that apply.
So 1-5%?
Yeah, it's a very low number because we get a lot of people who haven't given birth, even though the advertisements say that you have to have given birth. We also get a lot of people from states we can't accept. We have to have a state that legally is safe for the parent or parents.
So you literally need to have a full HR department just for the screening process?
Correct. Yes, we have a lot of people working on finding the carriers.
我们与客户交流的过程当中，常常遇到客户希望能够把这些代母拴在眼皮底下监控，确保自己未来的孩子能够在出生前也受到最完善的待遇。但从务实的角度看来，通过专业的代孕和服务机构找到合适的代母，并且在怀孕期间与代母之间有顺畅的交流沟通，建立相互尊重和信任，才是可行的方案。慧怡祝您孕，祝您美孕成真，我们下周再会。